In this lecture, let us talk about the band stop filter. In the previous class, we discussed a simple low pass digital filter, simple high pass digital filter, and band pass digital filter. Okay, so let us continue our discussion on simple digital filters. So we introduced the concept of filtering, and we explained and derived why an ideal characteristic cannot be realized. See, there are two reasons for this, and the first reason is that the impulse response is not zero for n less than zero, right? H of n is not equal to zero for n less than zero. That is, an ideal filter is non-causal. Okay, necessarily non-causal. And the second reason is that it is unstable, because h of n is not absolutely summable. For these two reasons, we were unable to realize a digital ideal filter. And then we said because an ideal characteristic cannot be realized, and the actual characteristic must have a pass band. Okay, and let's say this is my pass band. If it is ideal characteristics, it will be like this: must have a pass band, and then there is a transition band, and then you have stop band. Okay, if we take a practical filter, then you'll be having these three bands. So the character of the transition band determines the quality of the filter. The narrower it is, the better is the filter. The sharper is the rejection of unwanted frequencies. See, in this region I don't want the response, but still I have the some response which is appearing at the output. Therefore, if you design a filter which has a sharper transition, then your filter is very good. Okay, and then we took an example of high pass filter, a numerical example we took, and we showed how to design the filter by taking a minimum possible order. Okay, two constants are to be determined. So the minimum possible order was 3. Okay, not quite, you could have 2, but if you have 2 samples, for example alpha plus beta times z inverse, this is virtually one constant, because this I can write as alpha times 1 plus beta by alpha times z inverse. Okay, so it has only one constant. On the other hand, if you have alpha, beta and alpha, then it is a special kind of filter. So we will look at it more carefully at a later stage. So we took an example and showed how to design the filter so that your desired frequency is a single frequency. Now it was a single frequency, the magnitude is 1, and at the undesired frequency again one frequency only, and the magnitude was 0. So we took that example was x of n is equal to cos of 0.1n plus cos of 0.4n. If it was a band of frequencies, obviously you cannot have a flat characteristic over a certain bandwidth. Why not? Because the flat characteristics when I say flat characteristic, this also an ideal characteristics. So whenever you have ideal, then it's not possible to realize in practice. So flat flat characteristic over a certain band, absolutely flat, is not possible. Okay, so even though if you draw like this, this is not possible. Okay, absolute flat like this. No, this absolute flat is not possible. There will be some small variations will be there. Ripples will be there in the pass band, or ripples will be there in the stop band. So you will never be able to realize a flat characteristics in the pass band, because that is also ideal. Similarly, if you wanted zero transmission in the stop band or zero transmission over a band of frequencies, once again it would be an ideal filter and it cannot be realized. So in the pass band, in the stop band also, you will be having some ripples or some little bit magnitude. You will be never be able to realize zero in the stop band, okay, zero transmission over the stop band. So if it was a band of frequencies, then all you can do is approximate by 1 or 0 within a certain tolerances. So instead of saying flat, I can say I can allow up to this value, so that there will be some ripples like this. So this is one excuse me, and this is my tolerance, let's say delta p, passband tolerance. So this point is 1 minus delta p. Similarly, in the passband, I can allow this much variations. So this is called a delta s. It is 0 plus delta s. Okay, this is a delta s. Okay, so you can specify the tolerance. Okay, so you can specify the tolerance in decibels in the passband, which will be very small. And 3 dB, if you define, that is a very rough filter. It is a very loose or low quality kind of filter. 3 dB is very high value. And a 60 dB or 80 dB attenuation in the stop band. Okay, here it can be like a 60 dB or 80 dB attenuation. That means minus 60 dB and minus 80 dB. So that has to be specified. So how much attenuation you need in the stop band? How much is allowed in the pass band? Okay, we also said that in general, the frequency response h of e to the power j omega, what is this? This is the dtft of the impulse response h of n, which will be a rational function in, this will be a rational function in e to the j omega, e to the minus j omega or plus j omega. And there is no reason why we cannot obtain this h of e to the j omega from the z transform, provided the ROC of h of z must include unit circle, otherwise you cannot find out. If the variable is z, then you call it, how do you call this one? You call it transfer function. And here this is called a frequency response. There is no difference between h of e to the j omega and h of z. Okay, h of e to the j omega is equal to h of z on the unit circle, that is the magnitude of z is equal to 1. So h of e to the j omega is equal to h of z where mod of z is equal to 1. Okay, and then we took some simple FIR filters. We showed 1 by 2 times 1 plus z inverse is a low pass filter, and then half of 1 minus z inverse is the high pass filter, and I also told you 1 half times 1 minus z to the minus 2 is the band pass filter. Okay, if z in a low pass function is replaced by minus z, then low pass becomes high pass. Okay, so how do you go from low pass to high pass? Replace z by minus z, vice versa. High pass to low pass also you can go by replacing z by minus z. Okay, and I also gave you the reason, because minus 1 is e to the j pi, and therefore what is 2 at omega equal to 0 will now be true at omega is equal to pi. That is, your low pass becomes a high pass. This is in general true. If h of z, which is a low pass function, we replace low pass function filter, then replace z by minus z, h of minus z becomes high pass filter. Okay, in an FIR filter, this means that alternate samples are negated. Excuse me. Okay, alternate samples are given a negative sign. If you have a polynomial in z, then just to negate the coefficient, alternate coefficients. Okay, then we talked about a band pass filter, and we said if you cascade the two, that is low pass filter, then followed by a high pass filter, then you'll get band pass filter. Okay, 1 plus Z inverse multiplied by 1 minus Z inverse, you'll get 1 minus Z to the minus 2. This is your band pass filter, and this guy is low pass filter, and this one is high pass filter. So one can get a band pass filter by cascading low pass filter and a high pass filter. Okay, and we concluded the last lecture with the band stop filter. So band stop filter, I said 1 plus Z to the minus 2. This is band stop filter. Now let us discuss in detail about this band stop filter. So band stop filter, BSF. If you take the frequency response, that is put Z is equal to e to the j omega, then you get, let me write first of all, h of Z equal to 1 plus Z to the minus 2. And there is a multiplication factor I forgot to put here, 1 by 2. Then substitute Z to the e to the Z equal to e to the j omega, then h of e to the j omega is equal to 1 half 1 plus e to the minus j 2 omega. Again, do some simple, you know, algebraic manipulation. Here you can say 1 by 2 e to the minus j omega you take outside, then e to the j omega plus e to the minus j omega. Take this 2 inside, so e to the minus j omega times cos omega. So this is the frequency response of band stop filter. And cos of omega, as you know, now one has to be very careful, right? Cos of omega, if I plot, if I plot, then at omega is equal to 0, it is 1. And when omega is equal to pi, again, it is, let's say, minus 1. Let me take this as 1. Or I can take this like this. Let's say this is pi by 2. Like this. So this is my response, h of e to the j omega. Now if you take the magnitude, then what will you get? It goes like this, again it goes like that. Maybe let me draw. This is pi by 2, 0, this omega axis, it comes like this, then this negative portion will be flipped, it goes like that. And what is this? This is magnitude of h of e to the j omega. Okay, so therefore 0 to pi by 2 over this range, the phase is 0 degree. Okay, the phase is 0 degree of cos omega. Once it transits in this point at pi by 2, from positive to negative, here positive and here negative, the phase abruptly changes by how much? Pi. And therefore the magnitude of this, of course, will be the magnitude of cos omega, and at pi by 2 it is 0. Then it flips, okay, it flips like this, because we are taking magnitude, and therefore at this frequency, of pi by 2, the transmission is 0, and it is indeed a band stop filter. If you want to plot the angle phi, then this is minus omega, because you have the exponential function minus omega, but you also have to consider the phase angle given by the function cos omega. Okay, and therefore if I plot phi, then it will go from 0 to minus pi by 2 over this range. It is a negative phase angle, right? So it starts from 0, and this is minus pi by 2, it goes minus pi by 2 when the omega is pi by 2. At pi by 2, it introduces 180 degree phase shift, then there will be a jump. Okay, there will be a jump. This jump, how much jump? That jump is pi, because your cos function moves from positive to negative. How much phase angle it gives? Pi degree. Therefore, at exact, this transition occurs at this point, pi by 2. Therefore, initially the phase cos omega, this is a linear phase. This is a linear phase. Because of this e to the minus j omega, you have linear phase in this region, piecewise linear. The moment the omega becomes pi by 2, then there is a jump. Okay, so this jump will be there, and then again it decreases like this. Okay, it reaches pi. Okay, at pi by 2, angle of cos omega becomes pi, so it jumps from minus pi by 2. This angle is minus pi by 2 and this angle is plus pi by 2. Excuse me. Therefore, the phase plot is piecewise linear. One must be careful about the phase. Therefore, the angle of cos omega is 0. Angle of cos omega is equal to 0 degree for 0 less than or equal to omega less than or equal to pi by 2. So you can see in the, you know, in this plot, as we increase omega, phi also increases, but this phi increases negatively. Okay, negatively and linearly, because of the linear function minus omega up to minus pi by 2. But the moment omega reaches pi by 2, the cos omega enters into the picture. It provides pi radians. So therefore it jump in this jump will be there. Therefore, at omega equal to pi by 2, cos omega gives you pi radian, and cos e to the minus j omega gives minus pi. Therefore, the total angle at omega equal to pi by 2, at omega is equal to pi by 2, total angle will be phi is equal to minus pi by 2 plus pi, therefore it is pi by 2. That's why you reached this position. Okay, so therefore phi is equal to minus omega plus angle of cos omega. So in this equation, cos omega gives an angle of 180 degree at omega is equal to pi by 2. Afterwards it doesn't change until omega becomes 3 pi by 2, but we will not go to 3 pi by 2 because we are interested in up to omega, up to pi only, 0 to pi only, because our range of vision is 0 to pi. So the contribution of cos omega is 0 degree in the range of 0 comma pi by 2 and 180 degree in the range of pi by 2 comma pi. Therefore, I can write phi is equal to 180 degree delta of omega minus pi by 2 plus minus omega. This is a linear phase. This guy comes due to the e to the minus j omega. Okay, so therefore your phase plot linearly decreases and reaches minus pi by 2 when omega is equal to pi by 2, and then there is a sudden jump of pi due to this cos function, and then it reduces to 0 at omega is equal to pi. That's it. This is your phase plot. Therefore, the phase plot is piecewise linear. One must be careful about the phase. Okay, as far as magnitude is concerned, it is indeed a band stop filter. Okay, a band stop filter having center frequency. Where is the center frequency? If you look at here, this is my center frequency, right? It goes like this. This is the center frequency. So the center frequency is at pi by 2, and the center frequency is not the term for a band stop filter. For band stop filter, instead of calling center frequency, people will call it notch frequency, NOTCH notch. Okay, notch. And the band stop filter is also known as BSF, is also known as notch filter. Why is it called notch filter? Because notch is a common word. Okay, wherever there is a small hole, you call it notch. Okay, so this looks like a hole. Okay, so this region looks like a hole, so that's why it is called a notch filter. Now the notch frequency is pi by 2, and if you find the bandwidth, let me redraw here. It is like this. This is pi and this is pi by 2. You take 3 dB down from the maximum value. This is 1 and this is 0.707. okay, and this is the cutoff frequency omega 1, and this we call omega 2. And what is the bandwidth in this case? Again, in this case, okay, it's not 1 by root 2, it is still 1 by root 2 of its maximum value. Maximum value is 1, not the zero value. Okay, so if you divide 3 dB bandwidth, then two frequencies, omega 1 and omega 2, will come. Therefore, the bandwidth is equal to omega 2 minus omega 1. Again, this is equal to, if you find out, then it will be equal to pi by 2. You can easily show this. Actually, omega 1 would be, if you find out, then this will be pi by 4. And omega 2 would be pi by 4 plus pi by 2. This is, I think, 3 pi by 2, something. Okay. Is it 3 pi by 2 or 3 pi by 4? This is pi by 4 plus 2 pi by 4, 3 pi by 4, not pi by 3 pi by 2, 3 pi by 4. Okay, so that's it. So this is the band stop filter. Okay, so till now we have looked at the elementary digital filters, like a low pass digital filter, high pass filter, then band pass filter, and then now we discussed band stop filter. Okay, these all are elementary filters. For the band pass filter, for example, the center frequency is exactly pi by 2, and band stop filter, again the notch frequency, this is the center frequency for band pass filter. As I said, for band stop filter, we again the notch frequency is pi by 2. Okay, now the next question is, how do you design arbitrary band pass filter? Because this pi by 2 is fixed one. Okay, you can't change it. For low pass filter also you can't change it. Okay, that omega c cutoff frequency, you can't change it. For high frequency also, high pass filter also, you can't change the cutoff frequency. Now one can ask a question, okay, that I need to design an arbitrary filter such that my cutoff frequency or my center frequency is, you know, has to be customized. How can you design? How do you design an arbitrary band pass filter and arbitrary band stop filters? Okay, we will come back to a detailed discussion of this at a later date. But at this point of time, I have introduced to you some of the elementary filters. Okay, we have talked about four kinds: low pass filter, high pass filter, band pass filter, and band stop filters. But the problem in this is the cutoff frequency or the center frequency or the notched frequency, fixed one. Okay, these frequencies are fixed one. You can't change it. Now I need to change that. How can you do that? So that we will come back in a little later. Now the next question is, what about a all pass filter? I have to design a filter such that it can pass all the frequencies. Okay, with the FIR, finite impulse response filters, all pass filters are trivial ones. They have the transfer function of the form z to the minus n. You can't say, okay, if you put a straight line, that is all pass filter. No, that is not acceptable. Okay, so when I say h of z is equal to 1, this is not at all allowed. This is a trivial one. Therefore, there is no use in this kind of thing. This is wrong. So z to the minus m. And it introduces simply delay for all the frequency elements. Okay, whether you send omega is equal to 0 or omega is equal to 1, omega is equal to 0.1, 0.2, or omega is equal to pi by 4, or omega is equal to pi, doesn't matter. Whatever the frequencies you send it from 0 to pi, then it passes through without any attenuation. Okay, so if you take magnitude of this, then this is again equal to 1 for all the frequency components. Okay, so all pass filter is a filter whose magnitude is 1 or a constant over all frequencies. Its angle will be different at a different frequencies. For example, if you take z to the minus n, then you substitute e to the j omega, then what is the phase angle for this? Phi is equal to angle of z to the minus n. This is minus n times omega. So the phase angle is linear with respect to frequency. And what is the group delay? Let me denote this group delay, tau suffix g of omega, and this is the negative gradient of the phase with respect to omega. Okay, so this is defined as the negative gradient of the phase phi, and this is simply equal to minus n. In other words, if there is a group of frequencies transmitted, omega is equal to 0.1, 0.2, and so on, these all are group of frequencies. This is a very important concept in communication also, in analog communication, digital communication, wireless communication, something called, group of frequencies. These group of frequencies are transmitted through the channel. When I say channel, this channel can be a pair of copper wire, your telephone line, or a coaxial cable, or it can be air or vacuum, etc., or optical fiber cable, whatever it is. And then all the frequencies should experience same delay. Okay, for example, omega is equal to 0.1, it should experience n seconds delay. And this 0.2 also should experience n seconds delay, then there will be no problem. But different frequency component experiences a different delay, then you will be under trouble. Okay, so if there is a group of frequencies transmitted over the channel whose transfer function is, this channel transfer function is z to the minus n, then all of these frequencies will arrive at the output after n samples or n seconds delay. That's what we mean by delay. Okay, it is another way of saying, okay, that it is a delay of n samples. It can be n seconds or n microseconds or n milliseconds. Therefore, the group delay is the delay suffered by a group of frequencies. And if the group delay is not constant, look at here, this is a constant, right? If it is not constant, then we have a problem, because several frequencies start together. See, these all guys, okay, start together, but arrive differently. One guy will come later and one guy will come earlier and one guy will come correct time. Okay, so if all the frequencies start together and if they do not arrive together at the receiver, then there is a distortion. And that there is a distortion in the received waveform or the received signal, and that distortion is very, very bad for a communication system. And that is why constant group delay or linear phase is an extremely important objective in designing any filter or any communication channels. Okay, whether you design a filter or a communication channel, you must ensure that it must have a linear phase. Linear phase implies constant delay, okay? Because what is the group delay? Differentiation of negative differentiation of linear phase. Okay, therefore, linear phase is equivalent टू कॉन्स्टेंट ग्रुप डिले. ओके आइदर यू कैन से लीनियर फेस और इक्विवेलेंटली यू कैन से कॉन्स्टेंट ग्रुप डिले. दिस ग्रुप डिले जनरली पीपल विल डिनोट बाय टाउ सफिक्स जी. देयर इज वन मोर टर्म दैट इज फेस डिले दैट यू विल बी स्टडी इन सम अदर कोर्स. ओके टाउ जी ऑफ ओमेगा दिस इज ग्रुप डिले एंड वन मोर टर्म टी पी ऑफ ओमेगा दिस इज कॉल्ड फेस डिले. सो दैट वी विल नॉट कंसिडर हियर. ओके फेस डिले सो वी विल कंसिडर दिस अलोन. Probably you will be studying this in your electromagnetic course, electromagnetic waves and waveguides or antennas course. Okay, so that's all about a simple digital filters. Okay, so let me stop at this point. In the next lecture, we will discuss IIR filters. IIR means infinite impulse response filters. We will discuss this in the next lecture. So let me stop at this point. Thank you very much.